in the union movement. The coalition of black trade unionists is Angela. There she is. Thank you so much. Coalition of labor union women. Mary. Now, I'm only plotting these people for you because they're all going to try to sell you a membership before you get out of here, and that's a good thing. Labor Coalition for Latin American Advancement, LACLA, Gerardo Contreras. Texas Alliance for Retired Americans, Judy Bryant. She's taking tickets. And Jobs with Justice. Good deal. And Jobs with Justice generally mean. Okay. What did you tell me to do, Matt? Introduce Reverend L. Charles Stovall. Who in civil rights is more important in Dallas and Texas and internationally? The Reverend Charles Stovall. This is a man that we not only admire, that we not only look up to, that we not only follow, but a man that we love, Reverend L. Charles Stovall.
Associate Pastor of Savior Community United Methodist Church. And one of the things that you are lucky for this afternoon is that I am not going to sing. I want to thank my friend and brother Tunde, because not only is he a great songster, but their brother moves like nobody I've seen. Let's give him a hand right now. And I want to thank my friend and brother Gene Nass for this wonderful Songfest. And Gene is a person that I admire because Gene has been consistent in making sure that the issues of our day and our time are addressed in the way that they should be. And I appreciate his work and his leadership. Now, I'm a black pastor, and they gave me 3 minutes. and usually that's about one-third of an introduction. But one of the things that I want to make sure we understand and is that there's no need for a shotgun red wedding when it comes to civil rights and the labor movement. We don't have to be forced to work together, because from the very beginning of civil rights, the civil rights movement, labor was not only there, but labor was instrumental in making sure that the rights of those persons who we marched for and that we worked for were respected and honored. I know that there was a period of time when labor itself had to make adjustments in terms of the racism that our nation itself had put into the minds of many of our working people. Yet it's still, throughout its history, when labor began to understand its role in our society, labor had more cohesion, more diversity than any other institution in our nation. Names like Roy Ralph Wilkins and A. Philip Randolph are important names in the civil rights movement. In the March on Washington, there were some 20,000 people that were bussed in by labor. And before there was a March on Washington, there was a March for Jobs and Freedom in Detroit that was sponsored by the labor movement. So even the March on Washington was not something that only black folk or the civil rights movement was able to claim as its own. If it wasn't for labor, there would not have been a march on Washington. If it wasn't for people like Dion Forrester, there would not have been a march on Washington. It was labor that financed many aspects of the civil rights movement. It was labor that promoted the whole issue of jobs and justice in the civil rights movement. And that's why this is not a shotgun wedding. This is not something that is just stirred up in the mind of Gene and those who have put on this program. But it's honoring the reality that if it wasn't for the labor movement, there would not have been an effective civil rights movement. Dr. King's office was in a labor office. Before SCLC had their office, they were doing their work through a labor office. And labor and the civil rights movement have always been joined together. Many of the organizers of the labor movement helped organize the civil rights movement. And even as I stand here today, I think that it's important to recognize that when I was on the board of the Southern Christian Leadership Conference, a national board, for 10 years, one of the strongest men, one of the giants in the movement, was my deceased friend, James Orange. When we see James would always come and greet us with the "Hello, leader," because he wanted us to see the leader that was in all of us, whether it was realized at that time or not. James Orange raised money for SCLC and kept us informed about the importance of organizing people. And right now, civil rights and labor need to be working together. It's not us and them. It's all of us together.
Yes, sir.
When it comes to fair wages, we have to work together. When it comes to ending disparity between women and men in the workplace, we have to work together.
Yes, sir. Right.
When it comes to make sure that health care is available for all people, we have to work together.
Yes. Amen, brother.
When it comes to make sure that children have what they need in terms of having health and having what they need for education, we have to work together.
Amen, brother.
There's no way to separate workers from civil rights. That's why this Songfest is important, not so that we can all come together and sing Kumbaya, but so that we can leave here with a commitment to make sure that there's no turning back. There's no turning back. There's no turning back to a time when people and minorities and poor people were discriminated against. There's no turning back to a time when people were not respected in the workplace, when there was no dignity in the workplace. There's no turning back, because we are a people that knows what it means to move forward, to move onward, and to move upward. That's why I love it when Toonie led us in that song, "Stand up, get up. Stand up for your rights. Stand up, get up. Stand up for your rights. Don't give up the fight." And that's my word to you today. Stand up right now. Stand up. Get up. Don't give up the fight. Stand up. Get up. Stand up for your rights. Yeah. Labor. Civil rights. Working together. Working together. Working together. Thank you very much.
Reverend Snowball to draw two door prize tickets. So, hey, if he draws his own, well, you all see that they're mixed up, okay? And then when we're done, if you take the winning tickets out there, and there are four prizes for you to choose from, and we'll have the other drawing just a little bit later. Okay? Okay, this one is 377544.
Yay!
Dr. King said, "Negroes are almost entirely a working people. There are pitifully few Negro millionaires and few Negro employers.
Oh, thank you.
Our needs are identical with labor's needs. Decent wages, fair working conditions, livable housing, old age security, health and welfare measures, conditions in which families can grow, have education for their children, and respect in the community. That is why Negroes support labor's demands and fight laws which curb labor. That is why the labor hater and labor baiter is virtually always a twin-headed creature spewing anti-Negro epithets from one mouth and anti-labor propaganda from the other mouth." Dr. Martin Luther King.
Thank you.
There's a guy here named Matt Taylor who will not let me stick to the agenda, and we are going to change it slightly. And the next act will be Kenny Winfrey. He's going to perform a little bit now and a little bit later on. Brother Kenny Winfrey from Nashville, Tennessee, will be introduced by Matt Taylor himself.
Who are you, Matt?
Well, you're not telling who you are.
Who is that outlaw?
Hello, everyone. My name is Matt Taylor. I'm from the state of New Mexico.
We won't hold that against you. Yep. Y'all have any Democrats left out there?
We got a few. Excuse me, sir. Do you need to be escorted out?
I'm sitting at the ISD board meeting.
Who you got to get?
I imposed my will on Brother Gene Lance because I met Kenny Winfrey quite a number of years ago. I met him at a Songfest in Washington, D.C. Kenny has the most incredible voice and has the most incredible ability to write words down that make sense to the working folks. Back then, there was a new technology called a cassette. I didn't have a player, but I bought a cassette of one of his of his music. I've transferred that cassette over to digital, and now I have it in my iPad. So, Kenny, I don't need you to come up and sing, quite honestly. Because I hear your songs all the time, but honestly, brothers and sisters, this young man has an incredible voice, very unique. He builds airplanes for a living, and he makes labor hearts warm and snug with his voice. Please make welcome Kenny Winfrey.
My goodness, Matt, I thought he was going to introduce somebody else, saying all those nice things. Well, greetings from the United Auto Workers and also the American Federation of Musicians. Well, Stovall, is he still in the room?
Yes.
Thank you for mentioning Brother James Orange. James Orange and I worked together at the Industrial Union Department of AFL-CIO, and James Orange was an old friend of mine, took from us much too early, such a great speaker. He and I sang so many union songs together, and he was such a great guy. You know, one of the greatest things about being a union member is carrying a union card. I saw a picture here a while back in Wisconsin of some folks holding up their union card, and the sign said, "You can have my union card when you pry it for my cold dead hand." And I found out later that they had actually been singing, "I'm a union card," so I guess this is a good time to do it. Well, I was thumbing through my wallet just the other day, and well, I came to a certain spot, and I could have swore I heard somebody say, "Hey, I'm your union card. Now, don't you forget about me." So listen to this story, and just see if you don't agree. Well, you may not know it, but I do a lot for you. I protect your benefits and all your wages too. I might even keep you from getting fired, but just praise the Lord that I have a union card. Praise the Lord that I have a union card. Cause I could have been a Lisa, could have been a master child. Don't worry about your money, long I'm on guard. Just praise the Lord that I'm a union card. Well, I could have been the choker, could have been the old maid. Could have been the rooker, could have been the ace of spades. Living in your wallet here, it sure is hard. But just praise the Lord that I have a union card. Praise the Lord that I have a union card. Cause I could have been a beast, I could have been a master judge. Don't worry about your money long as I'm on guard. Just praise the Lord that I'm a union card. I'm a postal worker who delivers mail for you. I'm a textile worker and I work on airplanes too. I carry provisions over near and far. But just praise the Lord that I'm a union card. I pray the Lord that I'm a union card. You know I could have been a Visa, could have been a MasterCard. Don't worry about your money, long as I'm on guard. Just praise the Lord that I'm a union card. Well, praise the Lord, I'm a union card. Thank you.
Both of our next two performers are on night shifts, so they're really pressing their schedules to be up here, and I really appreciate their coming. When Dr. Martin Luther King was killed, you recall just about his last words were to request the song, "Precious Lord." Here comes Johnny Welch to sing that for us now. Johnny's the Civil Rights Director of UAW Local 848.
Good afternoon.
I was pressing my way to get here. I just got out of my church. I had to come from Fort Worth all the way here. Thank God for GPS. Okay, I'm going to do for you, Precious Lord.
Precious Lord, take me, lead me on.
Let me stand. I'm tired. I'm weak. I am worn
Whoa.